Contestants, Donna's ahead in this current game, but John's ahead in the competition between the husband and wife. We trust you'll be with us all week, and tell your friends, will you? It's going to be a delightful week on Password, and we need them, and we need you. The password today is work, and it comes from our good friend George Gobel, who says, hard work never killed anybody. But then again, resting is responsible for very few casualties. See you tomorrow. Have a good evening.
Some of our contestants will receive a serving tray and ready crust. Anything you like can be a pie with pie size, tart size, and toppings in a pouch from Johnson's and the Dirt People. Polynex, dial massage showerhead. The only massage and showerhead that lets you dial four different shower sprays, four great feelings furnished by Polynex. Light and easy. The lightweight iron from General Electric handles the same ironing job as a heavier iron. Hamilton Beach Mini Drip Coffee and Tea Maker. Brews 2 to 4 cups a minute. Fresh hot coffee only when you want it. Eliminates waste. Hamilton Beach Scoville. Be everything you can be with Mary Kay Cosmetics. Skin care and glamour cosmetics presented in your home by trained beauty consultants. Mary Kay Cosmetics, Dallas, Texas. A Walk and Lee Choi Chinese Food. Make your meal swing American with these fine Lee Choi canned and frozen products. A member of our studio audience will receive Edison Comfort Sensor Low Silhouette. Full room heater with thermostatic heat control. Multi-programmable timer. 27-inch wide blanket, a safe central warmth, burning climate. Go, Edison.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Password Plus, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
From Hollywood, it's the Newlywed Game! And here are today's newlyweds. This couple exchanged their vows 5 months ago to Miko and James McMichael. Our next couple tied the knot 12 months ago, Sue Ann and Demarius Pittman. This couple walked down the aisle 12 months ago, Jenny and Mike Serban. And our final couple traded rings 15 months ago, Monica and Tim Sombrano. And now, here's the star of the Newlywed Game, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Newlywed Game. We're glad you could join us today. We are going to have some fun, aren't we?
Yeah. Yeah.
Then I tell you, before the fun starts, let's get the ladies off to the soundproof room, and I'll ask the guys some questions. Ladies, if you would, please. Now, gentlemen, in round one, we're going to be asking you some five-point questions. You'll be answering these questions as you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. Now, remember, if her answer matches your prediction, you get 5 points. And also remember that each correct prediction brings you that much closer to that fabulous second honeymoon. So if you're ready to play this game, let's do it right now. Here's our first question. You ready, gentlemen?
Yeah.
Okay. Heidi, would you join me out here, please?
Gentlemen,
James, be quiet. Gentlemen, if you were allowed to have two wives and one of them was Heidi, between you, your wife, and Heidi, who will your wife say you would like to see have the most control in the bedroom?
I say me.
You want to have control?
I have to have control because...
Hey, Tim. That's going to be like barbecuing a steak with a pilot light. You know that?
Start the fire.
Oh, okay. Demarius.
I say me, because I'm always in control.
You're going to have control.
Yep.
Between
me.
You. Okay. James?
I'm going to be the man.
You're going to be the man?
I'm going to be the man. I don't have to be the man now.
Yeah, you are.
Before, I'm going to be the man now.
Mike?
It's definitely going to have to be me, Bob.
You're going to have the control.
I have to have control.
All right. Thank you very much, Heidi. Thank you very much.
Heidi! Yeah. Yeah.
Next question. Gentlemen, if we dressed you in one of your wife's bridesmaid's dresses, which of her bridesmaids will she say you would probably look better than? Give me a first name only, please, here, Demarius.
Sorry, I would have to say Lozman.
Who?
Lozman.
Lozman. Mm-hmm. So in a bridesmaid's dress, you would look better than Lozman looking in a bridesmaid's dress.
Because all the other ones look really, really good.
But this
one? She looked good, too.
Ah, yeah, don't bail out now, pal.
She looked good, too.
Yeah. James.
Lori, my girl, but I'll say Lori.
Lori.
Lori's a little bit, you know, thick.
A little bit what?
She's a little bit thick.
Thick? Is that what you said?
Thick, but she's cool. Just
trying to be. You've lost her as a friend anyway. Forget it, man. Don't try to be it. Mike.
I'm going to have to say Julie. That's her sister. You know, it's her. I don't know.
Julie. Yeah, all right. Tim?
I'd have to say Lena.
Lena?
Because look, I look better than her anyway.
Oh, you do? Okay.
Yeah.
All right, next question, gentlemen. How will your wife say you would complete this question? This is you talking. Most of the time, my wife is the perfect angel. But exactly how many days each month I swear horns come out of her head? James?
Once. I say once.
One day each
one
month.
Day. One
horns
day each
come
month.
Out of her head.
Yes.
Mike?
I'm going to have to say probably 2 days.
2 days?
Yeah.
Tim?
Five.
5 days. Demarius?
I have to say all important week, seven.
All right, gentlemen, thank you. We'll be right back to reunite the newlyweds. We'll see how well our husbands have predicted what their wives will say right after these messages.
Join me, Bob Eubanks, for my picks of some of my favorite episodes from Card Sharks, Trivia Trap, Match Game Hollywood Squares, Family Feud, and The Newlywed Game. It's the best of Bob during Bobtober here on Buzzer.
Continues tonight, starting at 8. Let's play.
Welcome back to the Newlywed Game. Glad you could join us today. Gentlemen, we recorded your predictions on cards. You now have them in front of you. Each time that your prediction matches your wife's answer, you get 5 points. One couple with the most points at the end of the show wins that wonderful second honeymoon. Ladies, welcome back. And speaking of ladies, Heidi, would you please join me out here? Yes, I want you ladies to meet Heidi, if you would, please. Your husbands have already met Heidi. Yes. Now, ladies, if your husband were allowed to have two wives, and one of them was Heidi. Between you, your husband, and Heidi, who would you say your husband would like to see have the most control in the bedroom? Jenny, who do you think he would like to have most control in the bedroom? You, him, or Heidi?
Me.
You. How come?
Well, I just really, I like to be very In control.
In control.
I like to be in control.
All right. He said for sure. Congratulations. He said he would have the control.
It's definitely me.
Yeah, definitely.
I don't think so.
No.
Yeah. No.
Is it okay if Heidi could be his second wife?
Huh? No way.
No.
Forget about that.
Tomiko, who do you think he's going to want to have control? Would it be him, you, or Heidi here?
Me. We don't need Heidi.
Oh, he said you do.
No, we don't need Heidi.
We don't need Heidi.
No, we don't
oh,
need
he
Heidi.
Said that the control definitely belongs to him.
You?
Yeah.
Me.
Why?
He's the man.
I'm the man.
He's the man.
That means I'm in control.
So where is she?
I can tell her to go to the closet while we...
Run for office, pal. Yeah. And Heidi's not coming out of the closet. I just want you to know. Sue Ann, what do you think? Who's going to have the control here?
It'd be me, Bob.
You'd want the control.
Yeah. I think Heidi was scared to marry us.
Do you think Heidi was scared to marry us? Does he get scared easy?
Yeah.
He does.
Yeah.
All right. He said that the control goes to him, the big guy.
Yeah.
Hey, Demarius, is it okay if Heidi's the other wife?
No, I don't need any more help.
Oh, okay.
I'm all right by myself.
Go over there and slap him with your hip. Oh, Monica.
I'd have to say him because I know already his macho attitude, how he is.
Oh, really?
So, oh, yes. That's all he tells me.
He's Mr. Macho? He
no.
No, I didn't think so.
It's a friend. It's
a he
friend.
Said control goes to him. You got it. Heidi, thank you very much. Thank you. All right. She scares me. Next question, ladies. Think about this one now. If we dressed your husband in one of your bridesmaids' dresses, which of your bridesmaids would you say he'd probably look better than? Give me a first name only, please. Tomiko? We're going to dress old James up in one of your bridesmaids' dresses. Which one of your bridesmaids would he look better than?
Lori.
Who? Lori?
Mm-hmm.
You know what he said? Card for me, please, there. He said Lori. You got it? Yeah. Sue Ann.
I'm sorry, Losman, but it's Losman.
Losman, he said, I'm sorry. It is Losman, yeah. Monica.
That's easy, because I only had two, so it has to be Liz.
Let's see if it's Liz. No, it's Lena.
Lisa's my maid of honor, not my bridesmaid.
Debbie.
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 All right. Your husband said Julie.
Julie.
No, not Julie.
Julie.
Why Julie?
Why Julie?
Julie's beautiful.
I know she's beautiful, but I you know, we always argue with your sister, and I'm...
You think you would look better than...
Julie's my sister.
Oh. We always argue with Julie.
You think you look better than her sister in a dress?
I have to look better than her sister in a dress. Hands down.
No way. My sister's beautiful.
Hey, good luck at the family reunion this year.
I know.
Here's the last of our five-point questions. Ladies, how would your husband complete this sentence? This is him talking. Most of the time, my wife is the perfect angel, but exactly how many days each month, I swear, horns come out of her head? Sue Ann?
One.
One. He predicted you would say seven.
Oh, wow.
Horns come out of your head.
Okay, all right.
Monica?
Well, I'm pretty good all the time, so I'll say maybe about five.
Five. He predicted about five. Okay. Jenny?
About three.
He said two. Oh. That's all right.
Well,
Tomiko?
You're nice.
Seven.
Seven. No, he said one day horns come out of your head. Aww. He thinks you're just sweet all the time.
Aww. Thank you.
Yeah. You want Heidi to join? No, never mind. We'll be back to see how well the wives can predict what their husbands will say. Welcome back. We've got such great new music. I really like this music. Play, no, don't play anymore. No. Ladies, now, your husbands are all secluded off stage, and it's your turn to predict what they will say. Remember, these are the big ones. These are the 10-point questions. Ladies, what will your husband admit he does more like a girl? Will he say it's the way that he laughs, walks, runs, or throws? Sue Ann?
It's got to be the way he walks.
He walks like a girl.
Yeah, yeah. His butt kind of sticks up real high, and he kind of, you know, goes side to side. Yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah, a little bit.
Gotcha, okay. Yeah. Tomiko, which one does he do more like a girl? Laugh, walk, run, or throw?
Has to be walk.
He walks like a girl.
Yes.
Big old James walks like a girl?
Yeah, big old James. James has a real high big butt, you know, so it is.
Well, he walks like a big girl, doesn't he? Yeah. Jenny.
Definitely laughs.
He laughs like a girl.
Yeah, he gets this real high-pitched shrill. It's really cute. I really like it.
Great. What do you think, Monica?
I'd have to say run, because my husband's not a runner.
He runs so, like a girl?
He runs like a girl, because he's so tall, it's kind of like this. So I'd have to say he runs like
no
a girl.
No kidding. Next question. Ladies, by marrying into your family, will your husband say he took a step up in class or a step down in class? Tomiko.
James took a step up.
He took a step up in class.
Of course. Well,
good for him.
That's my family.
Jenny?
I would say a step down.
He took a step down in class.
Only economically, but we both have incredible families.
Okay, that's nice. Monica?
I'd have to say he better be nice to my family, so I'm going to say take a step up.
He took a step up in class when he married you.
But I love his family.
Oh, sure, yeah, so. But yours is just classier than his. Yeah. Sue Ann?
I love his family, too, but he moved on up like
he
a Jefferson.
He moved on up the ladder. Next question, ladies. How will your husband say you would complete this sentence? This is you talking. My husband loves blank so much, he could make an infomercial about it. Jenny?
He loves karate.
Karate so much, he could make an infomercial out of it.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Monica?
I'd say ice cream.
Ice cream.
Loves ice cream.
Yep. Okay. Sue Ann?
Sports. Well, he's a fanatic.
Sports, is that, you want sports okay, or do I need to pin it down? Sports, we'll take sports.
It's the whole gamut.
Yeah, it's the whole thing.
Yeah.
Tomiko?
Sex.
Sex! I don't want to see that infomercial. Next question, ladies. Here's our 25-point bonus question. What will your husband say is the first name of the last woman he danced with besides you? First name of the last woman he danced with besides you. Monica?
I'd have to say Dinah, his mom.
Dinah. Sue Ann?
I'd have to say Renee, his mom.
Renee. Tomiko?
Robin, my mother.
Robin. Jenny?
Sharana.
Sharana. All right. Ladies, thank you very much. We'll be back now with our husbands to compare answers on the Newlywed Game right after this.
Now with celebrities.
Betty White, Didi Khan,
Marianne Mobley,
Elaine Joyce, Robert Mandan,
Richard Klein,
Rita Moreno.
Weekdays at 8:30 on Buzzer.
of our couples have scored points. Couple number one has no points at all. Oh, don't cry. Let's see how well you can do it. We're going to see how well the wives have predicted what the husbands will say. Remember, these are the big ones. These are the 10-point questions. Here's our first one. Gentlemen, what would you admit you do more like a girl? Would you say it's the way you throw, laugh, walk, or run? James, which one of those do you do more like a girl? Your wife had three answers. I had to put her down to one.
I say walk.
You walk like a girl. Gosh. Let me see. She said you walk like a girl. Yeah. Demarius, which one of those do you do more like a girl?
I say walk.
You walk like
a
girl.
My butt sticks out a lot when I walk.
You what?
Because my butt sticks out a lot when I walk.
It does. She said that you definitely walk like a girl. Yeah. Mr. Macho.
Yes.
I wasn't talking to you, Tim. What do you do, Tim? Throw, laugh, walk, or run like a girl?
I throw like a girl.
Let me see. Oh, that's what you throw? Do it again. You're right. She said that there's two things you do. You run like a girl, too.
You run like a girl.
Yeah. Mike?
I'm going to have to say laughs like a girl.
You laugh like a girl.
I look kind of like a... kind of like, you can know, you know what I mean?
No, I don't know. What do you say
really
I
high,
know?
Really high and a kind of
let me hear
thing
it
at the end. that thing at the end is what makes it
boy,
fun.
Boy, how embarrassing in a movie theater. Oh, God. Okay, your wife said that you you laugh like a girl. Yeah. Next question, gentlemen. By marrying into your wife's family, would you say you took a step up in class or a step down in class? Demarius, did you step up or step down in class when you married into her family?
Well, I didn't step in any direction, but...
No, she had an answer. Bam, well, just like that.
For the answer's sake, I say step up.
You stepped up. Yeah. She predicted you would say you stepped up in class. Yeah. Hey, Tim, did you step up or step down in class when you married into her family?
I definitely stepped up in class.
Definitely, huh?
Yes.
All right, she said you definitely stepped up. Yeah. Mike.
I definitely went up, Bob.
You stepped up.
Big steps.
She said, definitely, you did big step down.
Economically.
No.
But all our families are awesome.
No, your family's awesome. We stepped up.
Yeah, but your family
what's
is incredible.
Matter?
We both love each other's families, so that's
oh,
a hard
that?
One for
hey,
us.
You know what? Then I'm not going to pick on you at all.
Thank you.
Getting weak in my old age, you know. Normally, I'd say, oh, ho. Well. Yes, James? What do you think here, pal?
Moving on up.
To the east side.
No, to the west side.
She said, you're moving on. Up, yeah. Thank you, George. Next question, gentlemen. How would your wife complete this sentence? This is her talking. My husband loves blank so much, he could make an infomercial about it. Tim?
I'm going to say sex.
Sex? Your wife said that you love, card please, ice cream so much you can make an infomercial.
You eat ice cream more than when we have sex. What are you talking about?
What's your favorite kind of ice cream, Tim?
Rocky Road.
Rocky Road. It's going to be that way at home, too. Mike?
I'm going to have to say surfing, Bob.
Surfing.
I love to surf.
So much you can make an infomercial, all right?
Definitely.
She said that you love karate so much you can make an infomercial out of it.
That's true.
But thank you.
Dota?
I try.
Why are you looking at me with your mouth open like that, James? James, look at me.
Pasta?
Pasta? Pasta? What she
know.
Said? She said, you're going to make an infomercial out of pasta? She said, you love sex.
Oh, yes! Oh.
Next time he wants to get romantic, give him some linguine. Demarius.
I'd have to say golf, because I'm a golf
way
nut.
To go, man.
Yeah,
that's you and I make an infomercial. She said, you love sports so much.
Now, all sports.
sports.
Yeah, she's in all sports. I was going to pin her down. No, it doesn't work. Hey, before we get to our 25-point bonus question, let's see where our winning couple will be going on their second honeymoon.
You're going to Mexico. You'll stay at the Hotel Cabo San Lucas, a complete beach resort where you can do everything under the sun or nothing at all. White sand beaches, elegant dining, and deluxe accommodations, all with private terraces. The perfect second honeymoon. Back to you, Bob.
All right, Kramer, thank you very much. Gentlemen, here it is, your 25-point bonus question. Gentlemen, what's the first name of the last woman you danced with besides your wife? First name of the last woman you danced with besides your wife. Couple number one, Mike and Jenny. You have 10, 25. Gives you 35. Take over the lead, Mike, for the correct answer.
I would have to say...
Hurry, please.
My mother.
What's her name?
Rita.
Rita. She said, you danced with Sharana. Couple number four, Tim and Monica. You have 20, 25. We give you 45. First place, if you get it right.
I have to say Rose.
Rose. Your wife said you danced with... Dinah.
Rose was not at our wedding. Your mother was. Jeez.
Oh, man. You wore Rose's dress, remember? Couple number two. James and Tomiko, you have 25. 25 to give you 50. Get it right, you'll be in first place. James.
Robin.
Robin, she said. Robin! Yeah. All right, couple number three. Sue Ann and Demarius, you have 25. 25 to give you 50. Get it right, and you're tied for the lead. What's your answer?
Probably my mom, Bretna.
Bretna. She said it was Renee. That means a couple number two, James and Tamika. You're our Newlywed Grand Prize winners. Congratulations, you guys. Thanks to all of our couples, and thanks to you at home. I'm Bob Eubanks. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.